Welcome to Bibi Mimi Cooking Show.
So today we have my dad from Singapore who will be showing us how to cook some marinated octopus.
Thanks for coming, Master.
Thank you. Actually, I got an inspiration from our visit to Portugal early part of this year. I was very surprised the octopus turned out to be very, very tender. That's why I went to do a lot of research and then come out with this method, okay? And today I went to the shop to buy an octopus.
This is a very big octopus.
Wow.
This is
2 kilo.
This is 2.09 kilo, okay? So the first thing you do is actually use vinegar and salt. I go wash many times. At the same time, I try to massage. So make it more, prepare it for the tenderizing process. Okay. So another thing that we try to avoid is to peel off the skin.
Okay.
Because we want to maintain the skin. If you don't have skin, you peel it off later.
After tenderizing,
okay? To prepare the tenderizing process. You must get the hot water ready. You heat up to be about 100 degrees and let it cool down slightly.
So boiling and then bring it here?
Yeah, bring it here. A few ingredients, you can put as much as you want to the hot water. First thing we do, we pour some olive oil.
How much?
Just about 2 or 3 teaspoons, that's all.
Tell me when?
Tablespoon.
Okay, that's enough. Put some lemon juice inside.
Okay.
Okay.
Just one lemon?
Half lemon
One lemon. Then throw some garlic inside.
A few cloves?
Yeah, just about 3 or 4 cloves, yes. Then we just put a bit of onion.
A whole onion?
Whole onion, yes. And if you like, you can put a quarter of the orange.
The juice or the
whole? The juice.
Okay.
And then put a bit of spring onion. Okay?
So just the white part?
Yep. Okay, that's it. You must put one spoon full of the salt inside.
Is this enough?
Yeah. Okay, now you catch the octopus. You don't want to shock the octopus, so you want to be very gentle. Let it dip for a short while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come out. Okay?
Okay.
Then dip again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And come out. Okay? That's it. Two, three or four times. That's good enough. And after that, you dip the whole thing inside. Okay, that's it. The whole idea is not to boil it, but you to maintain the temperature. I did our own trial and error. It's better I put in the oven. The oven can control about 85, 90 degrees, and we leave it there for about 1.5 hours. So what I do is that I use the oven here, I control 85 degrees, so that I want to make sure the water maintain at this temperature. Okay, so and we leave it there inside, and I
probably
so
2 hours,
after 1.5 hours I check to see whether it is the octopus is already tenderized. Okay, now we are preparing the marinade, the whole process, how to marinate the octopus. To test whether it's tender enough or not, you just put. You see, go through quite easily. Okay. Now we will prepare to marinate the octopus. Okay. The olive oil.
How much?
The whole idea is to fill up
completely. Submerge.
Yes, submerge the whole. So you put half first. Let's see. Okay.
Okay.
And then we put one spoon of
tablespoon of salt.
Yeah, tablespoon of salt. Yes. Then we can put some garlic. Chopped garlic. Depending on what you want, okay? Because I like garlic very much.
Okay.
And because this is also another very important process. When we take the octopus out, during the cooling process, they absorb whatever flavor we want to have in the octopus. Then we put some orange juice, lemon juice. We put a bit of shallot inside, spring onion, okay. Some
coriander.
Okay. Now I quickly take out the octopus before it's cool. I think because it's quite big, so what I want to do is I'm going to cut into separate
Tentacles.
Tentacles, okay?
Okay.
So what we do is that, you see, it's quite easy to cut. And the most important thing, you can see the whole octopus still look very nice. And it is really, that means we have not destroyed the integrity of the octopus. Okay, so this first piece we put inside first, and then we stir. I just want to make sure that it is properly submerged. So we probably need one whole bottle. I think that's enough already. Yep, it's enough.
Do you have to add rosemary as well?
You whatever flavor you want, you put a bit of rosemary, you will absorb some of this flavor. If you can leave it overnight, then the next day, then you can start using it.
I think you absorb enough. More flavor?
Yes, you absorb more flavor. Okay? The third stage is quite easy. You can cut into small pieces to make salad. You can also make the Portuguese rice, octopus rice, and barbecue
or
grill or whatever.
We'll come back and check this out later.
Yes, that's right. By right, we should do it overnight. But I think so long as it's cool down, it absorbs all the spices, the flavor for spices, we can take it out. Let's try and see whether it's good or not, okay?
Can we try?
Yep, please try.
Okay.
Thank you.
How is it?
The texture is very good.
Okay.
Yeah, that's why if you want to make it even much softer, you actually can leave it in the oven for a longer time.
Okay. And I make a salad dish with this.
Yeah, okay.
So you can do anything with it, right?
Yes.
Thank you. Thanks for coming.
Thank you for being on our cooking show.
Thank you.